In our Sunrise Live here this morning, after a show of unity with world leaders of NATO, the European Council, and the G7 in Brussels, this morning President Biden is traveling to Poland, where he's expected to meet with U.S. troops and visit with refugees who fled the war in Ukraine. During the meeting yesterday, Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky, he addressed the summit in a video, saying if NATO stands for peace, then it must do more to save lives. President Biden, though, is promising additional sanctions on prominent Russians. He's also pledged to let as many as 100,000 Ukrainian refugees into the U.S. Biden also said he supports kicking Russia out of the G20 group of nations. And he said the U.S. will send more military support for Ukraine amid concerns that Russia would turn to chemical warfare.
Chemical weapons would totally change the nature of the conflict. It will be a blatant violation of international law.
As I mentioned, up to 100,000 refugees are expected to be coming to the U.S. So what will that even look like? Well, Ukrainians could come here through a range of pathways like the U.S. refugee program, non-immigrant and immigrant visas, as well as those who may already have some family here in the United States. A timeline and further details are expected to be announced at a later date.